Can we rely on cryptocurrency? I did a video the other day talking about some of the issues with the new Fed coin. The Federal Reserve is issuing a digital currency, and it's going into practice right now. And they're obviously using the auspice of, well, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get stimulus to people quicker, and we're trying to help the people. But we ultimately know where this is going to go. I talked about negative interest rates and some of the stuff that the federal government has been trying to do recently, some of the stuff they've been trying to implement onto the people. And so when it comes to this, and when it comes to you, your life, your crypto, can we rely on crypto? Should we just start investing all of our money in crypto? As a society, if we just went all in on crypto, would that be an option? Let's talk about Operation Save the Crypto. Now, this is an interesting topic because a lot of people have asked me that question. The one issue we have is the federal government does have the power to make cryptocurrency illegal. There's a lot of laws on the books that could make it really easy in a simple House and Senate vote, and really the president would most likely get behind it. In fact, there's a 100% chance he would. And crypto could be illegal in the United States inside of like 30 days if they really, really wanted to push. Now, a lot of people make the argument, well, Cody, they're never going to do that because of tax money. That is absolutely fundamentally not true. The federal government barely cares about your tax revenue, and most of you don't make enough money to have any tax revenue anyway that is substantial. Everyone cries about their tax. You ever seen people yelling at the police, like, I pay your salary? No, you don't. How much you make in a year? 70 million? Like, the average person is broke making 50, 60, 70 grand a year. If you make 70 grand a year, you may be paid for like 3 potholes, you kept the lights on in the library for 6 hours, and maybe you bought bootlaces for your local fire department. That's about it. You don't pay that much income tax. And then as far as sales tax, estate tax, and where these things are distributed, they're distributed in different areas. So everyone talking about how much tax they pay, quite frankly, about 5% of America pays like 98% of all of the taxes. And those are never the people saying, I pay your salary. So it's kind of a stupid thing. The federal government is not worried about your tax dollars also. And we've seen that this last year when they seemingly pump endless money injected into banks. And they've created a system with the banks where they can circumvent the average person. I talked about in a recent video where for the first time in American history, the rich literally don't need the middle class. That is why the stock market is still holding strong when all the other markets are in a bubble and they're getting ready to crash. Now, ultimately and fundamentally, the stock market will have some issues, but scarier yet is the bond market. And this is where the government's going to have serious problems. They're going to have a bond market crash, and that's going to cause some serious issues. That's going to cause some serious hardships when the bond market actually crashes. And so what do you do in that scenario when you're looking at crypto? Can't, as a society, we kind of pull off like what they did with AMC theaters or what they did with GameStop? Can't we all just go all in on a specific, you know, pick a coin? Well, unfortunately, no, because not only can the federal government make it illegal, but that's a system where the haves and the have-nots and the people who get in early are obviously going to make all the money. I mean, it's literally fundamentally a pyramid scheme, and the federal government would absolutely shut that down. And also, it could be called a pyramid scheme. When the cryptocurrency started to get crushed and Bitcoin almost got cut in half the other day, the SEC fielded more complaints than they pretty much ever have in crypto in the last 2 years combined. Everyone's calling crypto a fraud, because I talked about this during the shutdown, where everyone and their brother was getting into crypto because they saw it as easy money, and a lot of people were using money that they shouldn't have been using. And then when crypto finally crashed, because crypto's been going up for about a year, it's been going up steady for about a year, and then recently it's taken a big tumble. And a lot of people are screaming fraud. A lot of people are screaming they got ripped off, and they didn't. It's part of the game. What goes up must come down, and it's never going to go up all the time. But they thought it was a sure thing, and it wasn't. The only thing the SEC could do from here is crack down on more of the coins. I mean, I talked about this recently, where the founder of Ethereum, one of the most heavily used cryptocurrencies, period, has talked about how he thinks crypto is in a massive bubble. He's not surprised it went down. He thinks it's going to go down substantially more because of where things are right now. And so, yeah, we're in a massive bubble, and yeah, things are going to change differently. So can we rely on crypto? No, not at all. Now, the next thing people talk to me about is, well, can we rely on privacy coins? Can't we just use privacy coins and rely on them? Well, the answer is no, because the problem is privacy coins like Monero and Pirate Chain are great for private transactions. And I talk a lot about this because here at Privacy X, we believe privacy is a right and it's a right that needs to be protected. Now, if you want to learn how to live a ghost life, how to have a ghost business, how to live a life where you're not basically always under attack by the federal government, you can check out privacyxproject.com. We're always working with people over there on teaching them how to do these things. But regardless, privacy coins are only great for anonymous transactions. And quite frankly, at this point, they're barely better than cash. And it's debatable which one's better. Privacy coins have some good things for buying things on the internet, but cash is still pretty good. Obviously, what has been circumventing cash the last handful of years is facial recognition, but that's a different topic. But you've got privacy coins, cash, and then everything else. I mean, we've got credit cards, debit cards, digital money. We've always had digital money, but it's never been digitized in the form that they're trying to do now. Now they're trying to make a complete digital currency that is not backstopped by the dollar. It's a new currency. Right, where before it was a digital dollar, which is the exact same as a physical dollar. It has the same inflation, deflation, interest, etc., but you can utilize it in the form of a card. Well, now with this new currency system we've created, the federal government is trying to regain control with the Fed coin and a digital federal reserve, a digital federal currency, a digital central bank, which is what they've been talking about. And now it's no longer talk and speculation. It's what they're doing. And they're going to sell it as, well, we're going to use this to help you, to add value to you. But then long term, they're going to be able to use it to replace the dollar. Now, they're not going to be able to replace the dollar overnight, but they're going to replace the dollar soon. And this is one of the currencies they're going to use to do this. And this is what they've been talking about for a long time. And this has been the fundamental issue for several years now, is the federal government trying to find a way to replace the dollar because they can't control the dollar. Similar to the Corporate Transparency Act, where they came out and they're trying to control businesses. Now they're trying to control the monetary system with the dollar. They've always controlled it by the means of they've created, they've injected it into the banks, they've injected it into society. But once it's gone, it's gone. Right now, they've regained some control with digital credit and debit cards over the last several decades. But that's really only had so much of a backstop, and there's so many ways nowadays to do private anonymous credit and debit cards, not from the issuer, but from the user, and to keep your information anonymous from the merchant, right? And we've broken this down at great length here on Privacy X Project. So you can check out those videos. I highly recommend you do, because I give you a lot of tips on how to be anonymous in the financial situation. Well, this gives you a lot less anonymity. And the problem with cryptocurrency is cryptocurrency was never created to be anonymous. And the issue is the government is trying to create a digital coin that can be tracked and traced, and it doesn't fall under the same laws as the dollar, and it doesn't follow under the same monetary standard that we've always had. So it's not in God we trust. It's not under the Constitution. It's not the monetary system that was backstopped by gold and then ultimately taken off the gold standard, but was the original origin of this country. It's a completely new digital currency, which is going to give them a completely new set of rules and bylaws that they can create out of thin air. And they can pivot crypto into the Fed coin by offering bonuses and benefits that you're never going to get. And then if that doesn't work, they can use scare tactics and make it illegal to utilize these cryptos and push you into the digital coin, which, again, their ultimate goal is negative interest rates. And that is the fundamental issue, because if they're trying to backstop the stock market and the bond market from sliding, which they've done a pretty good job at ballooning this thing up with dummy money and getting corporate raiders to come in and pump up the stock market. They've done a pretty good job with that, but long-term, big picture, this is not going to last. And so they've really got to figure out a way to set up a structure to get the average person involved, because they don't need the middle class. They just need you to believe in their system, because once you believe in their system, it allows them to do all the things that they want to do, right? They don't necessarily need you. They just need you to partake. It's kind of like the big thorn in their side, one person, one vote. Well, they've circumvented that completely with the digital useless voting system and the Electoral College. They've been able to rig that system overall. And then now they're trying to let 14-year-olds vote because they want to vote in this new trendy monetary system. So the problem with crypto is they're using crypto against you as long as it's their cryptocurrency, right? It's not going to be your choice. They're going to make the choice for you, but it's going to be like a magician's sleight of hand. If I told you to pick a card, you could pick any card in this deck and I could tell you what it is instantly and you would have free choice. And it isn't because you picked the card you think you picked. I can force you into picking any card I want and you'll never know it. It's called a card force. And I could spread the deck open. You could pick any card you want, but I guarantee I know what card you'll pick before you do. And then you pick the card, I tell you, and oh my gosh, it's such mind-blowing. Yeah, well, you know what else is mind-blowing? They do the exact same thing to you. It's like a magic trick. They think you have choice, but it's an artificial choice, and they already know what you're going to pick because they're going to pump it up and give you the benefits. So the problem with crypto is they've used crypto as a training tool to get you interested in being in a digital currency, but this digital currency is not going to add any value to you. It's going to give them all the value, and it's going to allow them to control you. And in the end, they're going to give you peanuts. They're going to talk about, oh, we'll give you some stimulus. It's going to make it easier, but it's not going to add any value. So can you trust crypto? No. Is the blockchain technology and the future of blockchain promising? Yeah, but it's a database. Why are so many people romanticizing a database and blockchain? It's not that important big picture. What's more important is being in a fundamental situation where you have control of your life and you have control of your financial situation. And with the loss of the dollar, we've already kind of shimmy, shimmy, shake, shake away from gold and silver decades ago. And while gold and silver are precious metals and they do still have extreme value, it's kind of been pushed to the wayside. And now with this digital currency. So do I think we could trust crypto? No, unfortunately I don't. I mean, a much better haven is gold and silver, and a much better bet is backstopping the dollar. Even though the dollar has been weakened, it's been artificially weakened, and it can still be much stronger than any digital currency the Fed's going to put out. Anyway, really appreciate you checking this out. Let me know down below what you think about this. Are you all in for the Fed coin? Are you trying to hold on to your dollars to the best of your ability? They're going to pump it in the form of you're going to deposit your paycheck. You're going to think you're putting it in dollars, but it's going to start to say Fed coin. And it's going to be the same thing, but slowly but surely they're going to make the transition, which is already what they're working on. Go all in everything you do. Make sure you take action every single day. Subscribe and like if you haven't already, because putting out videos every single day, and I'll see you in the next video.